I was asked to cover the subject of preventive maintenance for the ship management company of the future. I decided to refer to the near future and to what we are doing today and what can be done more or less immediately on the issue of preventive maintenance. We have to make a good start. This is what my father was telling me when I was resisting to do something. Ιαρχήν το ίμιση του παντός. The ships must be well designed. We cannot talk about preventive maintenance if a ship is not well designed. What we normally do on new buildings is we are asking for a failure mode and defect analysis. This will give us the opportunity to see what can go wrong in case we have a single or a double failure. We are asking the shipyards to do an FMEA for the propulsion system, for the electrical system, for the gas burning installation, we talk about LNG vessels, and for the emergency shutdown system, and for the equipment that the major vendors are providing. This is a cost of, say, $30,000 to $50,000. The yard is subcontracting this, but we get a lot of useful information showing to us how we can operate the ships after their delivery. We are trying to get redundancy, propulsion redundancy notation for the LNG vessels, and we get it from ABS. And we are doing we are doing a propulsion redundancy decision intent. To give you an idea what this means, in case, two examples, in case of loss of one generator engine compartment due to explosion, the vessel shall be able to maintain speed minimum 8 knots with uninterrupted operation of generator engines, or the system shall have no single failure that can lead to loss of propulsion, loss of steering, loss of power, or other critical safety function. I think this is helping a lot in the new building stage. Talking about preventive maintenance, the way we see preventive maintenance is threefold. We have to talk about planned maintenance, we have to talk about condition-based maintenance, and we have to talk about critical and other spare parts. The system that we have implemented lately for spare parts is barcoding. It's like going to a supermarket. You mark all the spare parts that you have on board. Anything that comes on board is barcoded. Anything that goes out of the storeroom has to be barcoded. The established systems that we have for preventive maintenance is vibration monitoring, electric propulsion system monitoring, main generator engine condition-based monitoring, Wärtsilä is doing this for us, performance monitoring, online data transmission, which is very important, and I believe we are getting close to having the technology to get reliable data in the office. Thermographic inspection, we have IR thermal cameras on board, and sophisticated lubricant analysis in case we have a problem. Bunkers is another issue not so related to preventive maintenance. Examples, vibration monitoring, increased vibration on a main turbine. We got it in the office. We managed to solve the problem within 2 hours without immobilizing the vessel. Problems with the one feed water pump, high pressure feed water pump on a boiler. We only have 2 pumps. If you have only one in operation, it's similar to, you are getting too close to a failure. Again, we got the data in the office and we managed to balance the rotor without stopping the ship. Vibration monitoring, this is what we get on the diesel electric propulsion powered vessels that we have. It's quite a lot of information, but I believe it is more or less very, very useful. Electric propulsion motors temperature monitoring, it has saved us from at least one main converter failure. Main converter failure means that you lose half of the power of the ship. And a very good example, measurement of the DC link capacitors on the converters. By getting the information in the office, we managed to replace 350 pieces of installed capacitors without having a failure. condition-based monitoring. We send the information to Wärtsilä, we don't send the information to Wärtsilä. We give permission to Wärtsilä to get the information from the vessel. What we can get from this is optimized performance, optimized maintenance. They give us extensions for the maintenance that we have to do. And again, an example, we saw that one of the wastegate valves was not operating. We managed to recalibrate a converter, and this solved the problem without having to stop the vessel or talk with the chief engineer or. Performance monitor, this is information that we are getting online. We get the information every 6 seconds from the vessel, and we have developed in-house software allowing us to see how the vessel is performing. Pretty important for our relationship with the charterers. This is a screen that we are getting in the office every 6 seconds. We can see we have 4 engines on the vessels. We can see which engine is working, which engine is offline. The issue there is that if you operate an engine at 20-25% load, the efficiency goes as low as 35%. If you operate the same engine at 80% load, you increase the efficiency to 42-43%. Pretty important for the performance of the vessels. Thermographic imaging, this is something that everybody can do. It gives us the opportunity to detect electrical failures because all components, if you have an electrical failure, normally the components are getting overheated before failing. And periodic lubricants analysis. If you have a problem, normally you can get an indication on what is going wrong. This is about preventive maintenance. I just want to say a word because I will not stay for the, unfortunately I cannot stay for the Q&A session. There several speakers referred to 3D printing. We have discussed the issue with, and of course I'm talking about the next few years, not about 2030. We have the issue with equipment makers. There are several legal issues, for example, who will guarantee the part that you will use for replacement, what will happen if the part fails, but the main issue is a technical issue which has to do with the materials that we can have on board. We can do O-rings on board, but we cannot manufacture on board with 3D printing components for which special materials or special hardening, for example, is needed. Thank you very much.